Now, a novel about old tragedies and new crimes. Jeff is back to introduce you to what's on the NewsHour bookshelf.
They're the criminals who get away with something awful and become an obsession for the police officers first assigned to the case. Richard Price calls these men the Whites after the great white whale in Moby Dick, and it's the name of his new novel. Price is well known for his 8 previous novels, as well as for screenplays for films and TV, including The Wire. Here he writes under the pseudonym Harry Brandt, and welcome to you.
Thank you.
We'll get to that pseudonym business later, but first let me ask you, why police stories? What's the fascination for you?
Well, because I don't want police stories per se, but I usually write about areas that are very panoramic, like Harlem or the Lower East Side, or, you know, a small urban city like Jersey City. And I found the best way to navigate that big panoramic landscape so it doesn't look like a travelogue is latch on to a crime that is indicative of the tensions in that area and follow the investigation. Investigations are chronological and they're orderly and they bring in everybody, witnesses, family, the housing projects where both the victim and the perp live, the yuppie that was in Colorado. Yeah,
and when you say indicative, so you mean you are looking at something larger.
I'm looking for something that will show the shifting tectonic plates in a place that if it's being gentrified, yet there are lifers, you know, have grown up in poverty in that area. And if an encounter takes place that involves something violent between the two, and if I follow the investigation, it's my spine through an amorphous big amoeba of a geography.
And how concerned are you to get the details right? Because I've read interesting things about research, spending time with police officers, but then it sounds like at some point you throw it all aside and just write?
Well, what happens is I won't take copious notes, but I'll always, you know, take notes. But when I go home, I look at them and they're on steno pads and I can't remember if I wrote like this or like that and it's illegible. And then after a year, I figured whatever I don't remember wasn't worth it. Whatever was important to me, I don't need to look up in my notes.
This idea of the Whites, as I said, this sort of obsession that a lot of cops get with a case that they never could solve, that was a way, and you write about a group of young police officers and sort of even as they age, some out of the police force, they're still obsessed. This was a rich vein for you to tell different kinds of stories?
It's a phenomenon that I discovered. I started out hanging out with a detective squad in 1986 to write Sea of Love, the Al Pacino movie. And the first guy I met had an obsession with a highway shooting outside of Yeshiva University where 2 Yeshiva students were killed. Nobody ever caught
in
the
Manhattan.
Guy. Yeah, and he was obsessed. He was going off into retirement with this case. Now, he's in an area where there's so many more bloody crimes with so many more victims, yet this case somehow spoke to something in his gut that he couldn't get rid of it. And the more I hung out with detective squads, the more there was always one guy or 2 guys or a woman who had a case that they were the primary on years ago. It was never solved. And they take that case into their retirements. They'll go home to drink a couple of beers. They'll go through files that they stole. And they'll call up relatives from upstate New York or, you know, nobody interviewed the coffee guy that served coffee to the guy that we know is the shooter.
And for you, it becomes backstory and backstory and then layered kinds of stories.
But I love the personalness and the mystery of why this crime and why this detective responded to, and it's like malaria. You know, they can't get rid of this obsession. It comes and goes till the day they die.
Let me ask you about the pseudonym. I want to pull the cover back up. Richard Price writing as Harry Brandt. Did you want to write not as you, but then you were you? Explain this.
What you said.
Yeah?
I originally wanted to write a book that was going to be purely genre, unlike my other books that were like, you know, barbell weights.
genre meaning a crime. You wanted
I wanted to write a straight up urban thriller. And what you see is what you get, and all you care about is who did what to who.
Yeah.
You establish the characters, and you just go, phew. And what happened is, what's supposed to be a 6-month bang up job became a 4-year obsession of my own. And it turned out just like any other book with my name on it. So at this point, I regret that I took a pen name. It's kind of confusing. But at the time, I had my reasons. And by the time I realized I didn't want to have the pen name anymore, it was too late.
Makes for a good story, though, at this point.
It do.
All right. We're going to continue this conversation online. I'll invite the audience to join us there later. But for now, Richard Price, writing as Harry Brandt, The Whites. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.